If you want to know what's going on in Rockingham County government, check out Rockingham County 411. If you're interested in county governmental programs, projects, and services, don't miss Rockingham County 411. Public Information Officer Mabel Scott will share important, crucial news you can use with Rockingham County 411.
Rockingham County 411, you're in a good place, and today we're talking to our Chief Executive Officer, our Rockingham County Manager, Lance Metzler. We are glad you found time to stop by.
Glad to be here today, Mabel.
Yes, and we want to talk to Lance about what's happening now. We have so much going on. Please give us an overview of the pandemic first.
The pandemic has been a trying time for a lot of us in public management. I've talked to my counterparts across the state. We've compared notes, and there's really no best practice because we've never dealt with this before. So we're taking strides to do things in this time of uncertainty to make operations for our staff and it's very comfortable for our citizens to be able to come and conduct business over here at the county offices. As we've talked about before, you were involved with it as well. When this pandemic first started, we met on a Sunday, several hours in my conference room with a COVID task force that I developed and came up and developed a plan on how to approach it. And so I think we've done a very good job. Many folks have mimicked what we've done here in Rockingham County. It makes me feel good about our staff and the way we've done things. So I think that we've handled it as best we could. It is frustrating to continue to go on with this pandemic, but it's going to be around for a while, unfortunately, so we have to deal with it. So we are making some permanent changes to operations to make sure that, again, that our citizens are protected and our staff is protected.
That's the important thing. To add on to the pandemic, opioids epidemic.
Yes, so we've hired a staff person that, or contracted out with a staff person to oversee the development of strategies to combat the opioid epidemic. So you've got a pandemic and you got an epidemic going on at the same time. Just to give you an example, we had 200 overdoses this year, and the year still got a few months left. Back 7 years ago when we had 21 overdoses. So you can see it's continuing to be a very frustrating and a very concerning epidemic that we're dealing with. This type of epidemic does not discriminate. It goes over all boundaries. And, you know, the average age, I think, of the deaths that we've had, the county is 47. So you would think
that's
younger.
Young.
And you would think older, but no, it's 47. So it's very, very scary.
Wow.
And I think the issue that we have here is when somebody is addicted to a drug such as that, it's hard to wean them off of that. So we need to have some sort of plan in place to focus on a detox facility. There's limited space throughout the state. We've got one facility in Winston-Salem that we rely on that Cardinal has developed, but they're limited in space. And, you know, Forsyth County is a lot larger than we are. Mm-hmm. So typically a lot of times we'll see that space utilized by residents of Forsyth and Winston-Salem, then Rockingham.
And when you look at the pandemic plus the opioids epidemic, you're talking about money, money, money. So what about our fiscal responsibility? Stand in the black.
Well, we had a discussion, the North Carolina Association of City County Managers. I'm the vice president this year. Mm-hmm. And the president, Martha Page, with the city of Mooresville, we had a discussion with our state auditor, Beth Woods,
Beth
regarding
Woods.
North Carolina, the fiscal responsibility in North Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
But I must say, Rockingham County is very responsible, very strong. We have a strong administrative team. We've kept the same tax rate or lower for the past 11 years. We've improved our unassigned fund balance by 11% over that period of time. We have refinanced debt to the tune of about $3 million of savings for Rockingham County. So I think that internally with our staff, we're doing a great job as being responsible for the taxpayers' money.
Good people, good stewards. What about when you look at financial stability, it's looking good then?
Well, surprisingly, during this COVID, one would think that the sales tax would be down, the tax rate collection would be down, but surprisingly, our tax collection rate has increased by 1% from last year. Our sales tax has increased 12% from last year. And, you know, there's the folks are thinking, well, how'd that happen? And it's kind of interesting, I learned this, is that so the older adults and the parents that were accustomed to going shopping to the big box stores and places, when this COVID hit, the children taught them how to order online. And so now that the parents and grandparents know how to order online, they're doing a lot of that online. So that's a big hit where we got the increase in our sales tax. And you got to think, there's losses in the large counties like Guilford County, Forsyth County, Alamance County. It's because they were so reliant on those shopping malls, those big stores that we just don't have here.
Mm-hmm. And then the housing market, right?
The housing market, yes. It's a time of we've not seen a decrease in the housing market. It's actually increased, mm-hmm. and we're seeing several developments that are wanting to locate in Rockingham County. I believe that's a lot to do with the county being proactive, but at the same time, we have the resources, the infrastructure mm-hmm. here, whereas the upper part of Guilford County does not have those resources. And frankly, Guilford County is busting the seams, and people want to live in a rural area. I mean, Rockingham County is a wonderful place to live. We've got great people here. We've got your lakes, your rivers. You've got the rural character. That's very appealing to a lot of folks.
Natural scenic beauty.
Yes.
Let's look at some other issues. An aging population.
Yes. So baby boomers are our largest generation that we've seen, and they're starting to retire. And what is concerning about that is that is the ability, not really a concern, but really a shift in how we operate. So you look at your demographics to determine what services are needed. Mm-hmm. And so when you have a population that is aging, or those that are retiring in other places like New York, New Jersey, that want to locate down in Rockingham County, we have to make sure we have the services here to provide. And services such as the health care. I mean, we need to make sure that we work with our public health and our healthcare community to be able to provide those services, as well as make sure that we have adequate EMS services and physicians here to be able to take care of those people that we love and want to bring and keep here.
The land use plan.
Yes. The land use plan, the one that we have now currently, was developed in 2006. So it's very outdated. And basically, a land use plan is the ability to give the county the direction. It's kind of like a map. It gives you the direction on where you want to be, what you want to look like in the next 5, 10, 15 years.
Your blueprint.
Yes, so we've been working with a consultant on the land use plan and the Unified Development Ordinance. Just to mention, the Unified Development Ordinance, the last time it was updated was 1986, to tell you how outdated we are with both of these. And it's also, what's being proposed is a very generous UDO that will be very customer friendly, development friendly, so that people are able to do things they need to, and less restrictive, which we think is important, particularly when we know that the property owners have their rights, and want to make sure that we maintain that, as well as a balance to make sure that their neighbors aren't impeded on.
Yeah, transparency, and we hear a lot about this, and you can just see with all these live stream meetings that we've had, and sending out information and disseminating materials, transparency is very important.
Transparency is very important, particularly this time in government. There's a lot of reluctancy from the citizens, for people to really trust government, particularly federal, state. And so I want to make sure that the local level, the people know that we're here for them, they can trust us. They can know where every penny that they contribute to the county goes to. It's kind of like living in a fishbowl. as a manager and as citizens. I know that I got called out twice for not having my mask on when the pandemic originally started, and it called to the public health department. So I want to make sure that when I go out now that I wear my mask. Mm-hmm. And people know who you are, and they want to make sure that you're taking care of their money. You know, the big thing for me is that when I spend some of these tax dollars for the betterment of the county, I take it personally because of the senior citizens out there, that some that can't afford
on fixed income
that can't afford things, and they have to split their medication just in order to get by. And I really understand that, and I appreciate that, and I want to make sure that we are as frugal as possible.
Succession planning.
Yes, so we talked about baby boomers retiring. Mm-hmm. Well, we also have baby boomers that are retiring within the organization. And the succession planning that we've started years ago was to be able to develop a strategy to hold on to that institutional knowledge, so that if we knew that somebody was retiring, we found a replacement to learn under that individual before they retired. So we are seeing a mass exodus at this time from government right now. Mm-hmm. They're being replaced by the millennials and the Gen Xers. Mm-hmm. But I think it's important to maintain and keep that knowledge that's lost when somebody retires here.
And that leads to the next one, multi-generational workforce.
Yes, that is that is a very interesting dynamic now that I've not seen in years past when I was managing my younger years. So right now you've got three generations. You got your baby boomers, you got your Gen X's, and you got your millennials. Yeah. And all three have different work ethic. So it's very interesting to be able to manage your employees in their 20s and then your employees in their 60s. But it's they complement themselves quite often. They, you know, the millennials, they're very tech savvy. Mm-hmm. And the baby boomers, they got as I said earlier, the institutional knowledge. So mm-hmm. combining the two, and the Gen X is just kind of complement both of those. So you kind of blend them in together, and it makes a very interesting operations.
Last but not least, technology.
Technology has really had an impact on government over the past, I've been in the business 25 years, and I remember we had the bag phones and the pagers all the way to be able to do, you know, transactions over your phone for your bank to iPads, to the computers. It's been a blessing and a curse at the same time.
And don't forget the Blackberries.
I forgot about the Blackberries. But you know, the it's been a blessing and a curse. A blessing mm-hmm. is you have easy accessibility. You're able to find things a lot quicker. The bad thing is that the cyber attacks out there, the folks out there that are intentionally trying to get on your technology and destroy it. So, but it's been a blessing.
And we're going to make it.
We're going to make it.
Yes. Back in June, we announced that you had been elected the first vice president of the North Carolina City and County Management Association. This is representing 100 North Carolina counties and 532 municipalities. This is important because within the next year, you will be slated to take the presidential helm. You'll be next in line. And Mr. Vice President, what has it been like? That's a prestigious position.
It's been an honor. I appreciate the faith that the other counties and cities and towns have put in my leadership. I've been with the association for 15 years, and it's been excellent. The association was developed in 1964, and the purpose was to make sure that we put out professional managers in the community. There are over 801 active members in the association. It's been a pleasure. I'm also going to be serving on the North Carolina Association of County Commissioners as an ex officio member, the highest ranking county official on the City County Managers Association.
So that's going to be
an honor to work with the Association of County Commissioners. But I'm looking forward to it. I strive for professionalism in our career path, And I want to make sure that we're out there trying to find the best candidates to replace the Lances and the Paul Murrays and mm-hmm. the other ones when they come up. Mm-hmm. I want to make sure that we got the talent pools out there and they're professional managers that are really out there.
And as you can see, this man has a million ideas and ways that we can innovate and meet the challenges to try to make Rockingham County a better place to live, work, and play. And so we want to end with this question. What do you see in the future, the next few years for Rockingham County?
I see a very, very bright future for Rockingham County. There are a lot of industrial opportunities. There's a lot of growth in the southwestern part of the county.
Growth.
Yes, in Reidsville, in Eden. I mean, the whole area is growing as mm-hmm. far as the and we'll probably see in the census if we're growing. But I truly mm-hmm. believe that we are. I see the infrastructure improving here. Mm-hmm. Broadband, you know, that's a concern for people, broadband.
Yes.
I see the economy improving here.
Jobs.
Jobs, absolutely jobs.
That's what's important.
And I'm glad to be a part of the growth in Rockingham County. The people here are great. I want to take care of my people.
All right. Any other lasting words you'd like to share with your viewers?
Just want to say I love serving Rockingham County and the citizens here. We have a great board of commissioners that represent you all in the community, and they're really willing and ready to roll up their sleeves and make sure that the best interest is taken at heart for the citizens and do what we can to make Rockingham County a great place to live, work, and play.
The best is yet to come. Thank you so much for joining us. Rockingham County, you're in a good place.